This video introduces how SAS deals with dates. Dates come in many formats. So here we're looking at the date October 18, 2004. And I'm showing examples of all the different ways that date can be written. So in our first example, we have 10/18/04. In the third example, we see 10/18/2004. And in the last example, I have it written out, October 18th, 2004. So we need to know how to read in these dates as they show up in these particular formats, and then how do we work with them in SAS. The question is, what do we want to do with the dates? Do we want to display them? Do we want to compare two dates, which one is earlier? Do we want to find the number of days that elapsed between two dates? So we want to figure out how many days or how many years between two dates. The problem is that dates do not subtract very well. So for example, if you have a date of March 2, 2003 and you want to subtract August 2, 2002, you can't just subtract the dates as I'm showing in this example. So SAS has special tools for working with dates. There are informats for reading the dates into SAS. So we use a formatted style input, and we looked a little bit at that when we covered the topic reading and data. And then there are special formats for printing dates. So dates can be printed in different forms. So even if you read in a date in a specific format, if you read in the raw data, you can actually display that date in a different format when you print it out. And then SAS has some functions for manipulating dates. When you read in a variable with a date informat, SAS makes the variable numeric. So to SAS, the date is a number, and that number is the numeric value relative to January 1, 1960. Since SAS turns it into a number, it is easy to subtract two dates to get the number of days between the dates. So here in this example, we're creating a variable days elapsed equals date 2 minus date 1. So the important thing to remember is that once SAS reads in a date variable, it treats it as it does any other numeric variable. So here's kind of an example program where I'm reading in three observations, and the variable that I'm reading in is birth date. And I'm giving it an informat MMDDYY10. So this raw data is in the appearance 03/03/1971. And the informat that goes with the date that has that appearance is the MMDDYY10. Format. If we do a proc print of birth date, notice that in the printout, the first three observations we see below the dashed line, birth date is expressed as a number. And this number is relative to January 1, 1960. So March 3, 1971 is 4,079 days past January 1, 1960. If we read in a birth date that's January 1, 1960, then to SAS, it has the numeric value of 0. In the second example, where I have proc print var birth date, and I've given a format statement, we see the birth date appears in the form of 03/03/1971. So even though it prints out looking like a date, to SAS, that date is a number. And that number is the number of days relative to January 1, 1960. SAS has a number of functions that make it easier to work with dates. Some of the functions that I am going to be talking about in the SAS demonstration video include the today function. So if you write today and then an open and close parentheses, it returns a SAS date value equal to today's date. And every time you run the program, if you run it on a different day, it's always going to be returning the SAS date value equal to that day's date. Another helpful function is the year diff function. So if you write year diff and you give one date variable, comma, and another date variable, it computes the years between those two dates. Another very helpful SAS function is the MDY function. And the way the MDY function works is that if you give three variables within the parentheses, the first variable representing month, the second variable representing day, and the third variable representing year, SAS returns a date value from that month, day, and year values. So the MDY function takes those three variables and converts it to a SAS date value. Another thing we are going to be talking about is how SAS handles two-digit years. By default, if SAS sees a two-digit year, it assumes that it is between the years 1920 and 2019. So if you have a two-digit year of 03, then SAS is going to assume that that year is 2003. There is options, though, that you can change the 100-year span using a system option called year cutoff, and it specifies the first year of a 100-year span. So if we say year cutoff equals 1900, then our 100-year span goes from 1900 to 1999. The last thing we are going to talk about is how we put dates into SAS expressions. So in this last example, I'm creating a variable Earth Day 05 equals April 22nd, 2005. And in order to use a SAS date in an expression, we write it in this format where we have the quotes, and within the quotes we have first the day, two digits for the day, three digits expressing the month, and then four digits expressing the year, followed by another quote and then the letter D. And we can use dates in this format if we want to do some kind of comparison, like if transplant date is greater than January 1st, 2000, we can actually write a statement like that as long as the date January 1st, 2000 is put in this kind of format, like the example for April 22nd, 2005. So again, once a variable has been read with a SAS date informat, it can be used in arithmetic expressions like other numeric variables. The SAS demonstration video Dates introduces you to how SAS works with dates, including special date functions.